eBay.
Mm-hmm. Hi, my name is Brian, and welcome to Kings of eBay. I've been selling on eBay for about 23 years, and I'm about to tell you one of the most important lessons that I've learned over my time selling, which is how to set up your eBay store correctly and how to be able to do proper discounts so that you're not stuck with inventory in your store that's been there for 3-4 years and that'll never sell. The most important thing is to be able to have your store already set up. Being able to create a store on eBay is pretty easy. If you need me to actually do a video on that, just let me know. I'm happy to do that as well. But let's assume that you already have a store. Now, go to your store page and click Manage My Store, which is on the top right. Once you click that, on the left, click Store Categories. Once you go there, you're going to be able to see that you may already have some categories, you may not. Let me tell you why I do things the way that I do. What I do is I don't really have categories for every little item. So if I have a t-shirt, I don't put everything in the t-shirt category. If I have a purse, I don't put it in the purse category. If I have electronics, I don't put it into an electronics category. Here's why I don't do that. I don't buy everything at once. If I bought 1,000 pairs of shoes and I listed them within 2 weeks, then that would make sense to put them all in a shoes category. But unfortunately, that's typically not how our business is. Our business is done that we list a bunch of stuff 1 month, and then 8 months later, maybe we get more of the same. So if you put electronics that you bought 8 months ago in the same category that you just bought electronics this week, then how are you going to properly discount those items? Because you don't want to discount an item that's been there for 8 months the same that you would discount an item that's been there for 3 days. Doesn't make any sense. So I do all of my categories like this. I go to the top right and I click add category, and you are going to add 10 categories, maybe more, but for the time being, it's gonna be 10 categories. The categories are going to be new, N-E-W, new, that's category one. Every item that you list immediately goes into that category, not subcategories. Then the other categories you're gonna have are 5% off, 10% off, 20% off, 30% off, 40% off, 50% off, 60% off, 70% off, 80% off. This strategy is going to take you a year to work. But keep in mind, the sooner you do it, the sooner you will not have dead inventory. Now, if you only list things on eBay that just stay in auction, then this really isn't for you because you never really have anything in a store anyway. Here's my recommendation. Do all of those categories. New, 5% off, 10% off, all the way to 80% off. Then, once you've done that, what you're going to do is you're going to go to Markdown Manager, which is on the left of that same page. You're going to click Create a Promotion, Sale Event, and Markdown. Once you click that, it's going to ask you to choose a percentage. Let's say 5%. So click Choose Items. Click Select Items. The category you're going to pick is Store. And then once you do that, then you can pick your actual category. We're gonna say 5% off. So what you've done at this point is taken, let's say all of your items, put them all in the one category called new. Whether they're in die-cast cars or shirts or whatever, no one goes to your store and clicks on all those little categories. Maybe a few people do, but for the most part, it doesn't help you with discounts. Because if you keep putting stuff in there that is new versus old, your inventory management will never work out. Never. Unless you know every item and you individually do every discount. I mean, that sounds like a hell that I don't ever want to live in. Take all of your categories that you've already had in your store, and we're going to do 5% off discounts on everything in your store. Click 5%, choose the items. This time, since it's your first time, it's gonna be every item you have is now in your 5% off category. Now, there's a chance that you may have over 500 items in doing this. If that's the case, then you can do, you know, different categories to start off. You can have 5% off A, 5% off B, 5% off C, until it starts to whittle down. Because on Markdown, you can only do 500 items at a time for discount, for each individual discount percentage off. Click Select All and then confirm by clicking Save and Review. Now name the event and sale event description 5% off. The date range is gonna be today, whatever the date is. and then click start now. Click the calendar and count 44 days from today. Make the time it ends 11:30 at night. So what you're gonna do is every single 44 days, you are gonna discount every item in your store from between 5 to 10% off. As this process goes through, you're gonna end up with all those items down to 30%, 40%, 50%. When you have items get to 80%, that's when the eureka moment goes off in your head to realize, I had a jacket on there for $100. It's now at 80% off at $20, and people still don't want it, which should tell you that you purchased an item that people don't want. Now, if you didn't do it this way, then that jacket could stay in your store for the next 3 or 4 years before you come to that conclusion. I've been doing this for about 10 years, setting up my store this way, and I fly through inventory. So it's very important that you have really good margins to be able to support this. But when you buy collections like I do, you know, you try to get them for as, you know, everything for as good amount of money as you can. And when you start putting stuff into your store individually, some stuff's gonna be a winner. Some stuff is gonna go immediately and it's gonna be able to sell 10%, 20% off. You'll see hundreds of items go. But there's gonna be a lot of clunkers in your store that you are unaware of. Things that no one will ever want. I'll do in future videos what to do with what I refer to as eBay junk. But for the time being, this is how to set up your stores. Once you list anything, it goes into new. That's the default category that you will be using. Then it'll go to 5%, then 44 days later it goes to 10%, 44 days later it goes to 20%, and a year from now, things will get figured out. You are going to fly through inventory like you never thought you were going to be able to. Thank you for coming here today and listening, and if you have any other questions or comments, feel free to write them. Please subscribe because I want to keep giving more information of things I learned like this. And I look forward to teaching you more in the future. Thank you.
Thanks of eBay. Mm-hmm.